Good afternoon, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for taking the time to watch my videos. Early this morning at about 2:17 a.m. local time, there was a magnitude 4.5 earthquake in West Texas near the New Mexico border. I downloaded two monitors and yeah, they did not fudge about the size of this earthquake. They've been getting so many earthquakes there. Only five people bothered to say that they felt it to USGS Did You Feel It website. USGS gave it an intensity level of 4, which means it was felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few, and at night it would have woken some people up. Dishes, windows, and doors were rattling. Automobiles would have been rocking noticeably. This was probably part of the Rio Grande Rift system. And we'll go to the location of that earthquake. Right there. You know, Texas has over 200 volcanoes. Let me bring this out. I was busy today marking out the different volcanoes. Let's see. We got Sierra Blanca. A whole bunch over here by the El Paso, Texas border. There's even a volcano. Let me find it. In Austin, Texas. Let's go there. There you go. You can see a red line drawn out here. This is Pilot Knob Volcano. And let's bring it out. This here is the Volcanoes Fault. It was formed because of the collision after the Pangean supercontinent split up, forming new coastal shorelines. It was a time of some really intense volcanic eruptions. This here is the mountains that were formed when the continents collided. The Ouachita Mountains. Also during that time, we had the Farallon Plate subducting. Yep, all the way over here. And yeah, that created a lot of volcanism. A lot of earthquakes, a lot of magma coming up. Yeah, can you imagine over 200 volcanoes in Texas? Let me bring this out. This is the Rio Grande Fault System that I got drawn out. It's actually very wide. It's all drawn out in red. And let's go to some of these other volcanoes. Look at them all. Yeah, New Mexico. Basically, you can figure all the mountains that were in Texas and New Mexico. They were all formed by volcanism. Look at them all. There is, of course, some earthquakes that USGS did not report. And I wanted to go through and show you some of the data that I pulled. I noticed these lines of melt. Yes, they are in fact lines of melt. Let's go to the seismic signature. And then I'll enlarge it for you. Okay, let me show you something. Get a little bit larger here. Yeah, we got the fault line. The Rio Grande slowly widening, separating, getting larger. But I noticed that we also have volcanic earthquakes. Yeah, look at that. Some with rounded tops. See that? Let me pull it over here. And we'll go here, which got me to, you know, looking into all these. Look at that. See, rounded tops. These earthquakes and, yeah. Yeah, and the line of melt that it was showing. Yeah, look at that. Now this is enhanced. It's enlarged. Now we are going through a lot of earth changes right now. The earth's magnetic field is weakening. And because of that, we're going to see an increase in earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. And yeah, can you imagine if there was a volcanic eruption there in Texas somewhere? The last earthquake that they are reporting for the last week is the 4.5, and you see it there in light blue. There was also a 3.1 right there, only 4 miles in depth. That's pretty shallow. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. And there was a 3.0. Now that was yesterday, and the 3.1 was also yesterday. There wouldn't be oil or gas in Texas if it wasn't for the continents colliding and the rift system forming. And I don't know if they will put in a stop order for this 4.5 earthquake. The University of Texas at Austin did some research about the oil and gas production, and it's worrying them because it's causing an increase in earthquakes. The number of earthquakes have been steadily increasing in the West Texas and New Mexico area, known as the Delaware Basin, since 2009. 68% of the earthquakes larger than a magnitude 1.5 were strongly linked to hydraulic fracturing, or the disposal of the product, the wastewater, into either shallow or deep geological formations. 68% is a lot of earthquakes. And there's been a lot down here, and I've talked about this in the past. Let me bring this out. I've talked about how different rift systems seem to have been reactivated. Rio Grande rift system being one of them, the New Madrid, and the Walker Lane, which goes into the Gulf of California rift system. Yeah, those three areas have seen a large increase in earthquakes. The Petrillo volcanic field, let me go over there real quick. I found that was really interesting. This area here, evidently erupted magma came up. There was dike intrusions. These are all volcanic cones. That erupted within just 3 days. They know that any volcano can erupt without any notice. So I thought this was interesting, that this area, geologists figured that within 3 days of earthquakes and uplift, yeah, magma came up and caused this chain of volcanoes. Right here we have two earthquakes, but they only reported the second one as a magnitude 2.3. The first one they never reported. That one would have been at 6:42 p.m. last night. This one here, 6:43. But like I said, this one here they didn't report. I don't know why. It was larger. The first one came in as a magnitude 2.96. The smaller one that they did report was a magnitude 2.3. Go figure. At 10:11 a.m., this is when I downloaded the information. Yeah, you can see there's another earthquake there that they have not reported. Let me pull this up and we'll go to the seismic signature. There it is, just about on both monitors. But I thought the line of melt was really interesting on this one. They very well could be having dike intrusion coming up from very deep. I don't know. Just about all of the volcanoes there in Texas were either dike intrusion or, of course, magma coming in. But most of them for the different volcanic centers were created by dike intrusion. So when I saw these lines of melt, I thought, oh my goodness, what is going on there in Texas? Look at that. Yeah, look at that. Just something to be aware of. I thought it would let you know. Yeah, like we don't have enough to worry about, right? Yeah, going through some of these. And then we got some in red over here. Right there. And another one right there. Yeah, how many of you knew that there was over 200 volcanoes in Texas? I certainly didn't until I looked it up. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you.